Are you feeling a bit... What you need is Leave an Online Radio. There, that's better. Hello, and welcome to a programme about COVID-19 parody songs. I put this show together because I became aware of just how many have been produced. As I show the clips, I'll be asking what makes a good parody, or perhaps not quite such a good one. But clearly a lot of very talented people have been putting their creativity to appropriate use during lockdown. Some parody songs are written to send up either the song itself or the performer, as, for example...
I'm 41, but look like I'm 8. 32 pounds is how much I weigh.
Baker really does not care for Pharrell Williams or the Happy Song, does he? But he knows that if the idea is to take the mickey, you need to get reasonably close to the original. It wouldn't work if his singer didn't himself have a good voice. More frequently, though, parodies are written to poke fun at something else, with the song itself provided a vehicle for satire. One much parodied song from a few years ago was the freak hit from Korea, Gangnam Style, which in a way defies mockery because its own video is already having a laugh at its star's expense. But in this widely watched send-up, the alleged singer cannot sing at all, which you may or may not find funny. But the target for his humour is the stereotype of the educationally challenged rural Norfolk farmer, and he does assume you not only know the song, but have seen the video, otherwise what's with all the silly dancing?
We got Norfolk style. Norfolk style. Sitting on a hay bale in the middle of a field. Waiting for my dinner, taters already been peeled. Sitting in my garden with a mug of nice hot brew. There is nothing better than a nice hot stew. I like wary boo. I like milking cows and sometimes even goo. I can't read or spell or even write again. Don't go out nowhere without my oldest coat. Without my coat. Cutting trees down, driving tractors. That's what I like, that's what I like. Cutting trees down, driving tractors. That's what I like, that's what I like. And that's just the way I like to live my life. We got Norfolk style. Norfolk style. We got Norfolk style. Norfolk style. We got Norfolk style.
Hey, inbred lady.
We got Norfolk style.
Hey, inbred lady.
Most COVID parody songs are of this kind, that's to say they are not mocking the originals, but using the originals to make some entertainment out of our present situation. So, what makes a good parody work? Well, for a start, you need to pick an original everyone will know, so how about Bohemian Rhapsody? Just one small problem. Freddie Mercury was among the best rock singers of all time, so if you're going to parody him, you had better have some decent lungs on you. Fortunately, this guy does.
Is this a sore throat? Is this just allergies? Caught in a lockdown, no escape from reality. Don't touch your eyes, just hand sanitize quickly. Of easy breath, even though wash your hands, laying low. I look out the window, the cure doesn't look flattered.
killed a man. I didn't stay inside my bed. I walked by him, now he's dead. Mama, life was so much fun, but now I've got this unforgiven pain. Mama, ooh, didn't mean to make them die. If I'm not
Security's typing, very, very frightening me.
Gotta lay low, gotta lay low, gotta lay
low.
I'm just a poor boy facing mortality.
He's just a poor boy facing mortality. Sparing his life from this monstrous day.
Touch your face, wash your hands. Will you wash your hands?
Bismillah. No, we will not wash our hands.
Wash your hands.
Bismillah. We will not wash our hands.
Wash your hands.
Bismillah. We will not wash our hands.
Wash your hands.
We will not wash our hands.
Wash your hands.
We will not wash our hands.
Never, never, never.
Mamma mia, mamma mia,
mamma mia, wash your hands.
COVID-19 has a sickness put aside for me,
for me,
for me.
So you think you can stop me and just shake my hand?
Reckon full marks for performance and production quality, but the lyrics a bit too dark to be hilarious. brace yourself, it's Leaven Online Radio. Hello again, I'm still Richard Bradshaw, but another day, another shirt. There are reasons I've had to re-record parts of this show to do with copyright, but I'm damned if I'm going to change the bits that were okay in the first place just for the sake of continuity. So, here's a very clever skit on a scene from Fiddler on the Roof, which actually has something new to say. It's not just about washing your hands and staying inside. Notice how close it stays to the original, even to the point of using identical lines in a completely different context. It's now less about getting a man, more about women's preoccupation with their looks, their need to get their beauty treatments done, and their competitive cattiness. Now, don't look at me like that, I didn't write it. Just had a laugh though, this is class.
Watching my cousin, she's let herself go. Well, in lockdown, why put on a show? No more self-preening, just give me a book. With cake as a perfect match. Manicure, pedicure, who sees my nails? Stuck here at home, who cares if I'm pale? I don't need bling, I have no need to be the envy of all I see. Yolala, to retouch her collar, grow it out. Oh yes, grace, a new thing, I see how. This saves us dollars, then we can be happy as anything. Manicure, pedicure, fake tan and wax. No need to book, I won't be back. Being in lockdown, I just go with the flow, so let me relax on my own.
Since when aren't you interested in spa treatments? I thought you just had your eye on your looks. And you have your eye on that rich guy's son. Well, why not? He's the most eligible bachelor, and I have no plans to be a nun. Why shouldn't I want the best? Because you're a girl who's let herself go. So what he sees after lockdown, he'll like, right? Of course, right. Awful, just awful. Oh, what kind of catch are you? We thought that you were young. You now look 42, but you're a nice girl, a good catch, true? True, they say that beauty's skin deep, but what if it is not? There's more to life than that. Don't ask me what. Career girl, don't think so. Look how your skin has dried. The outcome of all that mischief. You are wide, but you're a nice girl. Successful, right? Right. Who cares if you are clever or sweet to all in sight? Without a big makeover, you look a fright. Did you think you'd get that job?
Well, my mind's the best in town.
With no treatments, no facials, extensions, or Botox, you just look like a clown.
Manicure, pedicure, you know that I'm still very vain. Can't give up trying. Up to this minute, I misunderstood that I could look yuck for good.
When lockdown is over, first thing remember to get waxed and hair dyed. Maintaining my look is tiring. It's just that I'm terrified.
Manicure, pedicure, brand new veneers. COVID be gone, get me out of here. Facing old age is a girl's greatest fear.
So spa me a spa, groom me a groom, dye what you dye, wax what you wax. I'll take my beautician back.
Some of our COVID parodists are seasoned hands, and for them lockdown is simply a source of new material. Here's a guy who already has a following, and his latest efforts won't have done his reputation any harm. He's good at this, and we'll be meeting him again later in the show. Listen to what he does with I Want to Know What Love Is.
Hey, hi! I hope you're doing well. So, I'm not super dressed up for this because
I forgot I had this song because here's the thing about what's happening in my life right now. I have no concept of time. Is it May or October? I took the trash cans out at 9.
The trash hasn't come for 5 more days.
But the collection, it was over.
It's morning.
Nope, we missed it last week.
No! She said TGIF because she thought that it was Friday. But there are still 2 days left. And Wednesday is a dry day. This new life, it's confusing our brain. Our kids missed their online classes again. I've got a FaceTime, it's yesterday at 5. Wait, that can't be right. I wanna know what day it is. I thought it was Thursday. Yeah. I wanna know what day it is. 'Cause they're all getting. Made a really yummy guac, 'cause Taco Tuesday is a better day. So imagine mommy's shock when we told her it was Saturday. We all dressed up really nice for family pics on Easter Sunday. I think we may have disappointed Jesus Christ because we missed it and it's Monday. It's my life. I don't know the day or the hour. I don't know when I last took a shower. I just worked a full day, but my boss didn't call alright. Wait. What a waste. Man, I wanna know what day it is. I got this confusion. I don't know what day it is because of all this seclusion. I don't know what day. Tell me. I mean, I know you can't come over and physically tell me because of the quarantine. So maybe an idea is that you just like from across the street, you come over and yell it at me.
Just come over and yell at me.
You just want any interaction.
Just anybody, anything.
Just anybody interacting.
Let's go up tempo now with a parody that takes on not only the challenge of mimicking the original lyric, which is daunting enough in this case, but getting the band's sound right. No taking refuge in a pre-existing backing track for these guys.
Stand aside. Ha, 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 stand aside. Ha, 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 stand aside.
that awesome or what, but is it saying anything? My frustration with some of these songs is the lack of challenge to the message from on high. Aren't parodies supposed to be subversive? There's surely plenty of scope for criticising government policy, slowness to respond, its mixed messages and initial neglect of the care sector. But maybe that's too close to home. Anyway, here's a song that's had a lot of viewings and is perhaps one of the exceptions to the generalisation that COVID songs don't send up their originals. This guy is taking on Adele, having a go at her melodramatic, tortured, poor little me vocal, as well as conveying the angst of isolation, albeit in such an over-the-top way that you have to, well, smile, if not laugh.
Hello, it's me. I'm in California dreaming about going out to eat just a burger with cheese or a shaken margarita, baby, back ribs from Chili's. Hello, can you hear me? I am shouting out to neighbors who I used to like to see when we were outside and free. Is there something else to watch besides the news and Finding Dory? The social distance between us, and I'm freaking out. Just me and myself and I, and a stay home order that's breaking my heart, but it's clearly what we should have done from the start. Hello from Corona Live. I FaceTime call. Hello, how are you? Do your fingers hurt from scrolling through the cat memes on your iPhone? I hope that you're well. Did you ever make it out of that town before they closed the Costco? It's no secret that the both of us haven't showered yet. Hello to Corona Life. The snakes stay home till July. Jesus Christ Almighty, can you please send me strength? I'm so sick and of my own goddamn face. Hello from self-quarantine. I'm begging Amazon to please, after sending more soap, can you please figure out how to send a box of my friends to my house? I'm so bored. It's just
Some songs are so perfect that you must not even think of sending them up. Men have been hanged for less. But as with Bohemian Rhapsody, they're also a magnet for the more ambitious parodists. If you're going to parody Let It Go, you'd better make a good job of it. A botched job would be sacrilege. For a start, it's a woman's song, so what's with a guy trying to make something of it? Can he really bring this off? Well, yes he can, because he's got a story to tell, and one we can all relate to right now, given the increasingly disastrous state of our barnets.
I need a haircut, give me a haircut, I need a haircut now.
My hair grows wild on my shoulders tonight, and the barbers are long shut. In the kingdom of isolation, I'm being threatened with a short buzz cut. My wife is circling with the scissors in her hair. She's got some clippers now and she feels their power. Don't let her close, don't let her near. You know she'd even give a sheep a shear. She says, how hard can this thing be? I don't want to see. Let it grow, don't let my wife cut my hair. Let it grow,
let it grow,
let it grow,
let it grow.
Don't plunge me in haircut despair. It's not my thing to look like the Tiger King. Let my hair grow long, the length never bothered me anyway.
Let it grow, let it grow.
She is wanting a little quid pro quo, hoping I'll get busy dying as her roots begin to show. I'll dye those roots, I'll trim split ends. You know I love her to the max, but count me out of things involving wax. Let it grow, let it grow. Time soon, let it grow,
let it grow,
let it grow,
let it grow.
We'll be a pair of hairy baboons. One day we'll care and we'll fix our hair. But until that day comes, I just can't be bothered now anyway.
Just a hint there, he's also sending up the format, the multiple tracking his own voice trick. Like, you might as well throw a bit of that in. Like it's a doddle. Trust me, it's anything but. Good piano playing too, very unshowy but very precise. This guy has to be a pro. And here's another professionally done job that plays with its own format. And you might wonder if those guys are really playing those instruments or if you hear what they're performing. My suspicion is that the keyboards are just messing about. At least one of the guitarists knows what he's doing, but the drummer isn't even trying, so it has to be a backing track job. The singer is well up to it though, the claps are perfectly synchronised and it's well produced. Nice one.
No one told you life was gonna be this way. Your job's remote, you're broke, you're hiding from the plague. It's like you're always stuck in quarantine. And you might be there a day, a week, a month, or even a year. But I'll be there for you, washing my hands all day. I'll be there for you, standing 6 feet away. I'll be there for you, cause you're there for me too. You're still in bed at 10, your boss got you at 8. The Walt guy brings you breakfast. Things are going great. Your crazy uncle's been saying for years the apocalypse is coming, so stay home, keep watching Netflix. But I'll be there for you, cleaning all surfaces. I'll be there for you, never touching my face. I'll be there for you. You're there for me too. to be me, someone to face the day with, make it through all the rest with. So when I always laugh with, even at my worst, I'm best with you.
You might have noticed how much American material I've been playing. Well, I can't help it if there just doesn't seem to be so much British stuff around. But I really have no excuse for not including the next clip, because it's gone viral. Views in excess of 5.5 million. It's perhaps a more genuine expression of family life than the almost too good to be true Holdernesses. The tensions come through here, as well as the family's essential commitment to one another. But how many families of six could pull off something like this? They presumably have some background on the stage, but they're not household names yet. But after this, surely opportunity knocks.
One day more, another day, another destiny, shopping for online delivery. I've tried again only to find there's nothing till September time. One day
to be sexy.
Yes, you know.
about ABBA's Dancing Queen? Several attempts at using this as a basis for COVID entertainment have been made, starting with this, by some distance the most professional and complicated to have been produced so far. After one verse and a repeat chorus, with some of those lines getting closer to the original than others, but the message is a bit threadbare now. Isn't it tough being indoors, wash your hands, yada yada. But there's so much energy in the piece, you can perhaps forgive a certain lameness on the lyrical side. Next up, a solo performance by a lady who makes a point of not even pretending to play her instrument. Lyrically, I would say quite an improvement on the previous. A couple of good jokes in there. Rhymes you don't see coming, and quite close to the original.
To go. Sure, you may not feel sick, but that don't mean a thing. Make sure that your hands are clean. For the love of God, don't be that guy who's like, I don't care, I am 25. Time to face the music, everything's not fine. This is the circumstance. From New York to San Fran, it's time to self-quarantine, or we will be worse than Italy. There's no vaccine, so sit and eat all your cans of beer. Oh, yeah. Don't take the chance. Grandpa could die. Stay the hell inside.
But she too can only manage one verse and a repeat chorus. What a contortionist, though. Finally, a thoroughly weird attempt by a man. Not much of a singer, he doesn't know which octave to pitch in, but notable for being so left field, and because he already has an established presence on YouTube, this one has had a million viewings, way more than the other two, and it certainly has some quite hilarious moments. See what you think.
Ooh, yeah, I'm not wearing pants, I'm deprived, I've lost track of time and my life. Ooh, has no routine, my name's Colleen, I am the quarren queen. Friday night and my wine stock's low, I've literally got no place to go. I try to find a good series to forget everything. I find the Tiger King. He's married to some real weird guys. Carol Baskin is living a lie. She fed her husband to tigers. Everything is not fine. Very weird circumstance. The show's got me in a trance, 'cause I am the quarren queen. I lost my mind on day 17. Quarren queen, eating bread without margarine. Oh yeah, I'm not wearing pants, I'm deprived, I've lost track of time and my life. Ooh, has no routine, I watch that screen, 'cause I am the quarren queen.
And now to Five Times August. No, me neither. It's the brand name of a lovely American guy called Brad Skistimas. He records covers of other people's songs, he writes his own stuff, and he does parodies. Prolific as he is, he seems to churn these out rather too easily, and not all of them hit the spot, but for me, this one does. My sense is he would love to have written the original, and it suits his normal pared-down style. He uses the parody form to go just a little deeper into the question that is on so many minds right now. What do you do when you're Netflixed out? Take it away, Eric Clapton.
It's late in the evening, she's wondering what show to watch. She puts on her Netflix and turns the kid's profile off. And then she asks me, is Tiger King alright? And I say, sure, I guess we're watching that tonight. Seven hours later, realize it's 4 a.m. We're so proud that we made it. Tomorrow we're sleeping in. But then I remember what time the kids wake up. And I say, darling, there's no sleeping in for us. There's no sleeping in, because they get out of bed before sunrise. They come charging in for breakfast and they just don't realize how late we stayed up. We're 6 feet apart now, on opposite ends of the couch. We We have Amazon Prime now. We browse movie trailers for hours. And that's when I tell her, hurry up, decide. She says, I'm trying. I don't know what to watch tonight. And I say, darling, Police Academy 4 is fine.
Among Brad's other parodies is one of many you can find on Billy Joel's We Didn't Start the Virus, Fire. But you need a big sound to bring it off, so I won't play you Brad's version, which is just him strumming his guitar, as you just heard, but instead this, which just nails it. To a couple of 60s classics. The first one tells a tale hinting at the domestic tensions that lockdown has brought us. Okay, so it's entertainment and it's done with some class, but it's quite a dark number with an appropriately subdued video. After that, a lady has a bit of fun with an old Neil Sedaka song, and if you're going to multitrack your own voice unaccompanied, you had better have the technique and confidence to bring it off, or it will sound as big a mess as she looks. But she knows exactly what she's doing. She's another professional.
Will this lockdown ever end? I've got itchy feet again. Cabin fever got me creeping out the house while my wife's sleeping.
made a decision that I'd probably make again. Couldn't abstain from sneaking out in silence. In the streets I walked alone, finally was on my own. But found myself in a quandary. Promised my wife I'd do the laundry. Walking back when I saw the flash of blue and red lights that split the night. With the sound of sirens and then the naked light I saw. 10 police vans, maybe more. They pinned me against the floor. Copper said I had broken the law. I said, please let me go. I was just going to the store. But they ignored and said I have the right to remain silent. Cop said, brother, don't you know? At this time the shops are closed. In the argument I was forming, forgot it was 2:30 in the morning. My excuses like silent raindrops fell. The jail cell is where I was headed with sirens. And now I'm in the prison hall. The cop said you can make one call. It was the hardest choice of my life. Realized I had to phone my wife. Don't think I had it in my heart to say the laundry's still not done. I called the one. So I said to myself in silence.
Waking up is hard to do. Today has run away from me. Seems perpetually. Got no time for nothing new. Cause waking up is hard to do. Remember waking at first light. Going to work, then coming home at night. Now I'm stuck here, routines are through. And waking up is hard to do. They say that we must stay home to help COVID clear. How time's passed, has it been a year? Can't wait for all this to end. I wonder if I struggle to get up at 6 o'clock again. I beg of you, just stay inside. We won't beat this unless we comply. One day we will start anew, then waking will be hard to do. Waking up is hard to do.
Just before the very last song, let me play you a parody that jerks the tears more than splits the sides. It's based on Cat Stevens' Father and Son, and it really is performed by a father and a son, many miles apart and missing each other. The son is that man who calls himself the Kiffness again, and at this point I take back my earlier snide remark about his singing. He can sing, and sing well, he just wasn't trying on The Dancing Queen for some reason. When you hear his dad sing, you can tell where he gets his talent. We've been having a laugh about COVID-19 because humour is such a good coping strategy. Ask any undertaker. But here we are reminded about the emotional toll that we are having to cope with.
How's it there? Can you hear me?
Very well. How are things, Davey?
Yeah, no, Dad. This lockdown's actually really starting to take a bit of a toll on me. Like, I really...
I know times are pretty strange. Just relax. Take it easy. We're stuck at home. Through no one's fault. There's no place we have to go. Love your girl. Settle down. If you want, watch some TV. Look at me. My beer is cold and I'm happy. I was once like you are now, and I know that it's not easy to be calm when the world is going wrong.
No, it's not.
Take your time, drink a lot, eat your bananas before they're frot, for you will still be here tomorrow if you do not lose the plot.
How can I try to explain? Another day in lockdown, I'll go insane. I've spent one whole month in the same territory. And from the moment Cyril talked, I was ordered to listen. Now there's a way, and I know, Dad, I have to go away. I have to go, Dad.
Relax, my son, you're being strange. Just sit down, take it slowly. You're highly strung, that's your fault. There's not much you have to go through. Allow your girl to calm you down. Just relax, watch some TV, look at me. My beer is cold and I'm happy.
I know you've said that. All the times that I've tried to obey the law and stay inside, it's hard, but it's harder to be for it. I know you're right and I'd agree if my beers weren't all empty, but there's a way, and I know beer today. I know I'm making beer. Good to hear from you, Dad.
Likewise, Davey.
Keep well. Yeah, we'll chat soon.
Well, now the end of lockdown is in sight, although as we know it won't come quickly, so perhaps this is a good one to end with, a return to the Holderness family, who gave us that Foreigner parody earlier on. They look like a nice bunch of people, don't they? All of them get a piece of the action, including the children, with just a hint that Michael Jackson's moves are a bit weird. And this is the song I will leave you with. I hope you have enjoyed the show. My name is Richard Bradshaw, but yours isn't. So goodbye and keep your distance, just for now.
Each day is more like a creepy dream from a movie scene. All day at home with my family, can't see anyone. Put on pants, get a nail, turn around. Maybe go on a run. I see a friend, dive away on the ground. I never shower in quarantine, it's bad hygiene. And now I've taken up gardening, who have I become? Put on pants, get the mail, turn around. The people getting restless, and now just on the news, they've canceled all the rest of school. And we've run out of puzzles, and new shows to stream. But we got nothing left to do, but we gotta make it through, hey. Quarantine is not quite over. What if I can go out and see everyone until 2021? I can't see anyone until 2021.
for 40 days and for 40 nights. We've been in this room and we can't stand the same meal plan. Chicken again, on the edge, on the verge, breaking down. Yeah, we've given up most nights and just microwave these bagel bites. Parents, oh, 2 months ago, they show us homework and we would help, we would try hard. Now we give up and go watch Die Hard. They're too young. Everybody tells me, be careful what you do. Don't go around breaking all the rules. Hey, and I know that it's important, and we gotta stay at home. But I'm feeling so alone. I'm like a dog without a bone. Hey, hey, the quarantine is not quite over.